everyone, welcome to another video of Creative Movement with Lizzy. I'm so excited that you decided to join me today for this little jazz musical theater combination that I have. So basically how it's gonna work, I'm going to do it one time so you can see it in full, and then I'm gonna break down the movements for you guys to learn, and then we're gonna do it a couple times and then have our little performance kind of where we just do it. Does that make sense? I hope it does. Okay, so I'm gonna play it really quickly and I'm just gonna show you what it is. It is a little fast, so if you'd like to pause and go back for anything, have me re-explain something to you, go ahead and do that because we are online and we can do that. Especially since I tend to move a little quickly, so I'm sorry in advance. So I'm just gonna show you what it is really quickly and then we're gonna start learning it, okay? Okay. Alright, starts now, okay? Is again, it is a little fast, so feel free to pause this video at any time and go back and review anything if you need to. I'm gonna do my best to explain it the first time. So let's just start that. Okay, so the first movement is probably the hardest in the whole thing, in my opinion, just because it's a lot of different syncopated movements, which is basically just doing it at the exact same time. So, the first thing that you're going to do is your feet are the most important part of this movement because they're going to bend, okay? So if you can see that from the side, I'm gonna bend my knees and go up on what is called forced arch in dance. So you're gonna like do that, okay? You don't have to like go over super far, or like it's just a little quick thing. So you're going to do that with your feet, but you're going to do it to the different directions, okay? So we're gonna go right first. So we're going to put our heels towards the right. Okay, do you see that? And then we're gonna come back center, and then we're gonna go to the left. So heels towards the left, center. We're gonna do that one more time. So then it goes this way, and then down, and then left, and then down, okay? Now, the arms in that movement, you're basically giving yourself two thumbs up and then pointing at yourself. So you're going to be pointing at yourself because she's talking about, like, if you're looking at me. Wow, nice singing voice. So you're going to do those movements together. So we're going to do that slow, fast, a little bit faster, and then we're going to try it with the music. Okay, so you're going to start pointing at yourself, all right? And remember, you're going to bend your knees, all right? So I'm gonna count off 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, so 5, 6, 7, 8. Go right, left, right, left. All right, does that make sense? Okay, well, we're gonna do it just a little bit faster, okay? And then we're gonna do it again. So we're gonna do 5, 6, 7, 8, right, left, right, left. Now we're gonna try and do it a tempo, which is the speed of the music. So I'm just gonna try to get it in my head. So it's gonna be like 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? So that's the first movement, and keep that in your head because we're actually gonna do that later on in this combination as well. So the next thing is kind of like you're swimming back. So you're going to flex your hands. So you're going to keep them flexed like this is relaxed, or, well, this is relaxed, but you're gonna flex those hands and you're gonna keep your elbows kind of straight. And you're basically just going to backstroke, but in the air. Okay, so you're going to backstroke with your right arm. So take this arm and you're going to go to the back. Okay, so you're just gonna make a circle back, and then you're gonna do the same thing with your left arm. And then again, we're gonna do that with the right arm. And then we're gonna do it with the left arm. So those are the arms. Once you hear the music, it'll probably be a little easier to do this, but if you just want to like start like, you know, like moving with it, this is a bit of an old school move, I guess you could say. And then if you'd like to add head to that, what I like to do is I like to look at whichever hand is circling back. Okay? So, or the direction of the arm that is circling back. So if I'm going back to the right, which is the arm that we're going to start with, I'm going to go back. I'm going to look at that. Okay? And then I'm going to do the exact same thing on the left side. So I'm going to go back and look. And then we're going to do that one more time. So together, that's going to be like back and back. All right, so we're gonna try that just a little faster, and then we're gonna combine it with the other movement. So 5, 6, 7, 8, back, 2, 3, 4. Now it is a little bit faster in the music, so we're gonna do it actually just a little bit faster before we combine those two things together. So it's probably going to be like 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, if you just don't want to do it that fast, or if you're finding that you're not able to move that quickly, that is also completely okay. You can do it half speed. So instead of doing 4, you can just do 2. So you can go like 1 and 2. All right? Okay, so we're going to combine the two movements together. So the first thing, I'm going to count us off, and then we're going to try it, and then we're going to go a little faster, okay? Okay, so 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay? All right, if you want to pause it and go back, go ahead and do so now, because we're going to go a little bit faster and then we're going to move on. So 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, so the next thing that we're going to do, we're just going to move those a little bit faster and then we're going to learn the other part of this section of the combination. So ready, we're going to go 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's it. That's that part. And keep that in mind because we will be repeating that later on in the combination as well. So the next thing you're going to do a little drag or a little slide. So you just finished here with your left arm back and you're going, and your legs should be sort of close together. If they're not, that's okay. But that would be the ideal position. You're going to slide your legs out, like I said. You're going to bend your right knee, and you're going to straighten your left leg, okay? And you're going to slide, okay? And I know that some people probably have limited space, but if you had a bigger space, you could, like, slide. Like, you could make it bigger if you want to. Just be careful whatever you do so you don't fall down. So, again, if you just finished 3, 4, you're going to go slide with your legs. Okay, and then your arms are kind of going to mirror what your legs are going to do. So your left arm is going to be out straight, but then your right arm is going to be up. Okay, so when you slide, your arms were just here, and then you're going to bring them in just a little bit, and then they're going to go, wah! They're going to go out. Okay, make that like super jazzy and super cute. So you're going to go out, and then here, let me make sure you see my feet. You're going to take your left leg and you're going to cross it over the right, and we're going to do a little flippy doodle turn. So you're going to cross it, and then you're going to turn to the direction of your back foot, and that should give you your right foot in front. Okay? Okay, so let's do that one more time. That can be a little confusing. So if you just did your drag, you're here, then you cross your left leg, bring your arms down. So that's the turn, and then my favorite part of every combination I've ever created, chest hands. That is the next thing that we have to do. So if you'd like to like bend your, or pop, what's the technical term for keeping one leg straight and bending the other one, popping your foot. So if you'd like to do that and do a little chest hands, go ahead, because that is what I have next for you. That is chest hands. Yes, chest hands are great. Yeah, I'm sorry. So that is the first part of the combination, basically. So I'm just going to go over the second half again, then we're going to do it together, do it a little faster, and then do it with the music. And then you can have a water break, because I know that you probably need one by now. All right, so the second half of the combination, so you just finished your little backstroke thingies, so you're going to slide, and you're going to turn, and chest hands. All right? Okay. Okay, so we're gonna combine that with the first two things that we did, which were the little thumbs and then the backstrokes, okay? So I'm gonna count you down and I'm gonna call it as we do it. So 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, and back. 2, 3, 4, drag, cross, and jazz hands. All right? Okay, we're gonna do it just a little bit faster and then I'm gonna try it with music and then feel free to take a little break if you'd like to. So, what it is. So it's gonna be 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. Backstroke. 2, 3, 4. Slide, hold, and turn, and jazz hands. All right, are you good to try with the music? If you are, I'm going to play that now. If you'd like to go over any part of that first part of the combination, go ahead and do so now. All righty. So there's a little bit of music again. It's gonna start in just a second. I will tell you when it starts and I'll call it out, don't worry. All right. 5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. Back. 2, 3, 4. Drag and turn and just hands. All right. So that is the first half of the little combination that I have for you today. If you'd like to do that again, go ahead and back this video up and do it again just to make sure that it's in your body. But if not, we're gonna keep moving on. All right, so the next half is kind of a mirror of the first part of the first combination. You're going to do the little thumbs again, okay? So the combination, this part of the combination is going to start with the four of the thumbs and four of the back strokes. So it's gonna be 1, 2, 3, 4, back, 2, 3, 4. All right, that is the first half, so you should already know that part. Now, moving on, you just finished with your left arm back. You're going to take your right foot and your right arm and you're going to step and put your arm up, and then you're going to move a little bit, and then you're going to take your left leg and you're going to put it behind the other one, and you're gonna bring your arm down at the same time. So you're gonna step at the same time, put your arm up, and then you're gonna put your arm down and you're gonna step back. And when you step back, go ahead and look at your bottom hand. And again, that's a flexed hand. It's just a stylistic thing. You don't have to, but it looks cute, which this combination kind of is. So again, you just finished your 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Step up and back. And you're gonna do it to the left side. So you're gonna step with your left arm and leg, and you're gonna put it behind you with your right leg and your, this is your left hand. Yeah, that. So we're gonna do that one more time, then we're gonna combine it and keep moving on. All right, so you just did your third backstroke and four and up and down and up and down. Okay, now this is your ending position with your leg back like this. So I put another little turn in here. You do not have to do a turn since it may be a little bit confusing, but if you would like to try it, go ahead. Your arms are going to be pushing out to the side. If you've seen the Ballet Basics video, you've seen that this is basically what I like to call Star Wars arms because it reminds me of the scene in one of the Star Wars ones where they're in the trash compactor and they don't want to be crushed, so they're going like that. Star Wars arms. Those are Star Wars arms. So you're going to take your right leg, which is behind you right now, and you're going to turn behind yourself. So I'm gonna be turning that way, okay? You're gonna take that right leg and you're going to bring it into your left. So you're gonna be going like that and you're gonna keep turning, all right? So that's the turn. So you're here. And then if you wanna use your arms, you can go ahead and use your arms to try and get around. All right, I'm gonna try that as slow as I can while trying to turn. So you just landed here, so then you're gonna go turn here. All right, so that is the turn. I'm gonna go from the backstroke movement, combine it with the little arms, and then we're gonna keep going. So you just did the one backstroke, two, three, four, up and down, and up and down, and turn behind yourself. And the next part is just a little fast. Well, most of this is a little fast, but this is a little faster. It's what I like to call the Elvis. If you don't know who that is, please go find out. So you just landed here. You're going to take your right arm and you're going to put it to your head and you're going to turn like that. So it's kind of like you're holding like a hat on your head, sort of. So your feet, if they are here after the turn, your left leg is just going to dart out a little bit. All right. So do you see how kind of how that works? It kind of goes like, wah. All right, but then as you do that, you're going to do the little arm thing. So you just landed here and you're going to do Elvis. And then your other arm is just behind you. And then you're going to go ahead and do that to the other side. So you're here and then you're going to switch. And then where I'm looking during this, I'm looking like down and down. Okay? Again, if you'd like to go over that, please go ahead and do so. I know it can be a little confusing, especially since we are online, but go ahead and go over it. And if not, we're gonna combine those two together. Okay, so we're going to go from the little step thing into the turn, and then we're gonna do the Elvis, and then there's only one more move and then we're done. All right, so you just did your backstrokes. One, two, three, four. Step down, step down. Turn, Elvis, Elvis, and then the last thing, the very last thing of this entire thing, you're going to circle your right arm, you're going to circle it back, you're going to circle it halfway back, you're going to go in, and then you're going to go back, and you're going to point when you do that. Does that make sense? So you're going to go back. Back, in, out. All right? And when you do that, you can go ahead and look at that finger when you point. So you just did your little Elvis is. So you're going to go one, two, and then you're gonna go one, two, in, out. And then you're gonna jump together and jazz hand again. And that is it. That is the entire combination. So I will definitely go over that again. We're gonna go from the backstrokes one more time, and then we're gonna try the second half of the combination all together, all right? Okay, so you just did backstroke, 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 step, down, turn behind yourself, and Elvis, Elvis, swing, swing, stop, in, back, jump, jazz hands! It'll make more sense when I do it with the music, I hope. So we're gonna try all of that, the second half of the combination together. So we're gonna add the little thumbs at the beginning. All right, so we're gonna do that in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, I'm gonna count you off. Ready? So 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4. Back, 2, 3, 4. Up and down, up and down. And turn, and Elvis, Elvis, back, back, in, back, and jump, jazz hands. I know that I kind of rushed through that last part, so if you'd like to go ahead and go back and do that, go and do so now. If not, we're gonna try the second half of the music, then we're kind of gonna combine them two, and then we're going to do it. All right? All right. So here we go. So this is going to be the first part of the combination on this part of the music, but we're only going to do the second half for right now, all right? All right. All right, ready? 1, 2, 3, go! 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Turn and Elvis, Elvis. 1, 2, in, back, and jazz hands. I know that's a little fast, guys. But again, if you can not do something right now. That is completely okay. You do not have to do any of these. I just thought it would be a fun treat for you guys to try and do at home. Maybe you can show your families. So if you would like to go ahead and try that second part one more time, just because I know it's a little difficult to get, go ahead and do that. And if not, we're gonna try it all together. We're gonna see how it goes. All right? All right, so I'm gonna back it all the way up to the beginning of this part. And we're gonna do it just a couple times and then we'll be done today. All right? So here we go. All right, just follow me. I'm gonna be doing it and calling it out, okay? All right. Thank you for supporting this new program. Have a great day, everyone. And remember to always be bright, be brilliant, and be you. All right, guys, I'll see you later.